Ladies and gentlemen, all the way from Louisiana, Robert Powell. Give it up, y'all.
Okay, let's get it over with. How y'all doing, Atlanta? Good, good, good. Let me get this. They ain't give me that much time, so this shit gonna go real, real fast. I'm the new I've been in Atlanta for about 2 days. I've been since I got here. I'm ready to go. My first mistake was I went and ate at this Chinese buffet that they got around the corner from our room. It's good food at the buffet, too, if you don't mind shitting. If you don't mind, then I recommend the Chinese buffet. It's right around the corner from the room. Because I had to at the Chinese buffet. I had to there. I was sitting there eating with my friend Smooth Earl. He like, nigga, what's wrong with your face? I say, dude, I'm 2 centimeters dilated. I'm sitting in here sitting on myself in this Chinese. That Chinese food, y'all got real Chinese people cooking y'all food. We don't have that. I ate an egg roll. It was diabolical. That came right back. I ate that. I said, did I eat that or drop it? Let me get my up from here and go on to the back. I picked my plate up and walked off. The lady said, you need a to-go plate? I say, ma'am, I'm taking this to the commode. I gotta eat this in the bathroom. First time in my life, my thank to me. Normally, I could take my it's other folks I can't take. I was in there killing my self. Little Chinese like, you need another root beer? I said, bring me a baby wipe. I had to wipe my off. I tell you what the issue was, too. I don't know if you ever been to a Chinese buffet, but they got these red ribs on the buffet in there. You never seen this, ma'am? They got some dog red ribs on the buffet. Y'all don't have dogs? Corvette red ribs on the buffet. Don't f*** with that. That ain't for us. That's for them. Little lady gonna tell me, you left your fortune cooking. Bitch, stole my fortune. I'm gonna be blood all week around with this Chinese buffet. That's my fortune. Second mistake I made, I went to the nice mall y'all got, fantastic mall. Nice, whatever. I got hit on twice in the mall today. That's the good news. Problem was, both times it was by dudes. And I don't f*** around like that no more. I don't know what these Shaq people told y'all. I don't know what they told y'all about me on that damn internet. But me and Dunham McClurkin, we can change our lives. Yes, I said it. I don't give a f***. Okay, let me back up, because I don't need nobody outside protesting it. I don't have no problem with gay people. Some of my best friends are going to hell. So I don't have no, I'm not judging. No, don't owe me. That's in the Bible. I don't know the chapter, but it's in the red words. Check the red words. Them the important words. I ain't have no problem with that. You know what I'm saying? But my problem was the dude hit on me so convincingly that he had me think for a second. Now I'm not gay, you know what I'm saying? But this nigga hit on me with such gusto, like, I know you gay with me. And I'm not, you know what I'm saying? And if I was, I wouldn't be attracted to, well, I'm not gonna get into what I'd be attracted to if I was gay. Cause you're right, that's gay. I'm trying to explain. If I was, I wouldn't be, he was a girly, you know, gay. I'm not gay, but if I was, you know what I'm saying? Shit, I'm gonna need me a man. You're gonna have to work for this little ass. You gonna get it. I'm not finna just be giving that away. My mom ain't raised no slut. You gonna respect me in this mall. Girl, he had his hair all slick like Prince and and had these high boots on that women wear. Came over to me smelling like perm and pre-cum and whatever the Don't ask me how I know what that smell like. I didn't have no problem with that. The problem was he had this glittery lotion in his hand. And I reach out, shake his hand, pull my hand back. Now I got the glitter on me. Now, I don't know if you know this, but glitter is like the herpes of the arts and craft world. Once you got the glitter, you just glitter. You know what I'm saying? Now I got to walk around Atlanta all day like I didn't beat the of a unicorn or some shit. I haven't never beat the of a unicorn. I'm just assuming that if you do beat the of a unicorn, that glitter will come out. That's a safe assumption to make. I went ahead and gave the nigga my number because I don't know nobody here. I can have friends. Then the third mistake, they gave us this drive. I don't know why they put this nice mall y'all got in the middle of this bad neighborhood, but we got lost. And the drive ain't even from here, which is stupid. You know what I'm saying? We got lost in a bad neighborhood. And as soon as we turned down the street, I say, sir, just take me back to my room. It was everywhere. Lord, I don't know the name of the neighborhood, but we ain't got to live like this no more. Who is the mayor? God. This need to be shut the fuck down. It looked like a hated playground. Just, sir, white guy, this is the 47% Romney was talking about. You know what I'm talking about? Just them. Bunch of bad Black kids playing in the street, don't nobody want to move. Just no shirt, no ball, no, just a flock of failure playing in the street. I can say that. I'll move on because I see y'all sensitive about it. I don't know if y'all can tell, but I'm the asshole on the tour. I done got fired about 5-6 times too. Shaq fired me every other weekend. I got fired about 3 weeks ago. I'll tell you why too, but I thought I was well within my rights, you know what I'm saying? We're in New York, and at the University of Syracuse, this 18-year-old boy goes to band rehearsal, and then after band rehearsal, he goes back to his room and hung himself. Now, Shaq, with his nice ass, the first thing he said was, I wonder why the boy hung himself. First thing I said was, I wonder why the boy went to band rehearsal. If you finna go, then what the f*** is you rehearsing for? The Lord don't need no band if that's what you're doing. He should have been somewhere writing a note and dividing his up amongst his friends. We in Syracuse, New York, and I done walked right out on stage and said that. Probably was too early. The dude probably still dangling and shit, and I'm on stage making jokes about it. Oh, well. I'll tell you another time I almost got fired, too. We was at this party in Detroit, after party, at this club. You know, it's packed and shit, but it was a ghetto club, but, you know, whatever. And out the corner of my eye on the dance floor, I see this man in a wheelchair, and all he can work is this shit right here. I'm just telling the story. Paraplegic guy, but he getting drunk because he got a straw of Hennessy going to his mouth in the club. I don't know how he got there. I ain't seen no ramps. I ain't seen no handicapped parking, none of that shit. Well, sure as shit think a fight break out. Somebody, you know, everybody trying to get out of the club, people getting trampled and shit. Somebody knocked the man over, you know what I'm saying? Was kind of walking on him. Shaq saw it, went help the man get back in his wheelchair. I saw it, but I ain't see it. So I kept on running to where it was safe and secure. Shaq find me 15 minutes later. I'm outside standing by the police. He gonna ask me why I didn't help the man get back in his wheelchair. I say, Shaq, that man is paralyzed already. He can't feel none of that. Oh my, I'm not finna fuck up my good legs with dead legs at the club. I won't do it. I just won't do it. He the one with a motor. He should have gave us a ride about this bitch. He saw them people fighting. He could see. Now all three of us get trampled, now all of us in here in the Luther Vandross edition hover rounds next week. Yes, I said that too. That's my time, y'all. I'm Robert Powell. Thank y'all for having me. Whoa.